example for what happens. So like I said, that means that unbounded means that, you know, if you have that IL of t equal to IL of infinity plus IL 0 plus minus IL of infinity e to the minus t tau, or tau, tau is here L over R theta. If R theta is less than 0, then tau is less than 0, and then e to the minus t, this becomes e to the plus t over tau, right? And current goes, current rises exponentially. Right? That's why it's called unbounded response. It blows up, okay? And here's the example for that. So let's say you have a circuit like this. Okay, so this circuit is like this. It has this two metal plates with some gap distance, okay? So then when this switch closes, they ask you how long it's going to take for V gap to become fine T after switch closes when V gap is 30 kilovolts. That's a lot of voltage, okay, 30 kilovolts, okay? Which means it's going to blow up your circuit, okay? That's a lot of voltage, okay? Let's see how that happens. Obviously, V-gap is inductor voltage, right? So you'll have LVI, LVT, right? So V-gap will be equal, V-gap of T is LVIL. Fine, inductor current, yes.
What's the subscript on that current right above the inductor? Is that I2?
Is that I2?
Oh, that's IL, sorry.
IL of T, right. So it's a typical switching circuit, right? You need to find IL of T, plug it in to get your V-gap of T, and then plug in 30 kilovolts to find T, right? So that's how you do it. So to do this, IL of T is equal IL of infinity plus IL of 0 plus minus IL of infinity times e to the minus e over tau. Okay? Okay? So now, what do you guys think? What's, before the switching occurs, what's I of 0 minus, which is equal I of 0 plus? What do you guys think? That's going to be easy. Mm-hmm. So the switch is open. What's the current through inductor? So you have only this part of the circuit. What is it going to be? You have a dependent source, but dependent source, you know what it means. And basically, the I delta is 0, so this is basically open, right? So your circuit basically looks like this, right? T equals 0 minus. This and this. That is it. No, 2 ohms and IL 0 minus. So what is IL 0 minus?
0.
0, right? Yeah. Pretty simple to see that. So now switch moves. So for T equals 0 plus, your circuit looks like that. Now you have all that stuff, right? This resistor, other resistor, current source, dependent current source, you got inductor, and that's it. So basically, you have a 30 volts here, you got 4 kilohms here, you got I delta, you got 12 kilohms here. Okay, so in this case, you need to find what's going on at infinity. So if you look at the voltage at infinity, right, inductor at infinity, what's going to be? Short, right? Because this is a step response of our up, right? So at infinity, at T equal infinity, your circuit will look like this. So basically, what do we do with 12 kilohms? What do you guys think in this case? Can you do something with 12 kilohms in the circuit? What's the voltage across 12 kilohms in this circuit? Well, you have short, right? You short it, so what's the voltage? Get rid of this. There's no voltage, there's no current. So your circuit is only this, right? So basically you can do a KCL at this point, maybe. So it's going to be 7/7 of I delta is equal to I delta plus I L infinity, KCL. That's one. And then I delta, what's I delta? Well, I delta is basically Ohm's law, because you know there's no voltage drop across this, so basically voltage across 4 kilo ohms is 30 volts. So you have minus 30 volts divided by 4 kilo ohms, which basically gives you I delta to be equal to friends figured out. So I was left to figure out this tau. Tau is basically L over R Thevenin. Okay? You need to find R Thevenin for your circuit. So R Thevenin is basically what you do. Well, you're going to have this circuit. You deactivate independent current source, but you have a voltage source, 30 volts, but then you have a dependent current source. Basically looking for R Thevenin right here. So, 4 kilo ohms, you got 12 kilo ohms, you got 7 over 3 pi delta. So basically to do R Thevenin, you basically pick up, you can hook up test voltage, VPIP, and figure it out. Okay? So R Thevenin, yeah, basically over IT, and basically, you need to find that ratio. So KCL at node 1 will give you this is my delta right here, right? So KCL at 1 gives you that IT plus 7/3 I delta is equal. I delta plus VT over 12 kilo, right? And I delta, you can see that is equal to VT over 4 kilo. So basically, your IT is basically equal to delta plus VT over 12K, and then you have IT is equal here minus 4 3 over 3 I delta is VT over 4K plus VT over 12K, cancel 4 and 4, that gives you 12K here. Then you have a minus 4 VT plus VT. That gives you that that R Thevenin is basically VT over IT which is equal minus 3 kilo ohms. So seeing that a negative R Thevenin, right? You get a negative voltage, or Thevenin resistance. Actually, this is 4 kilo, not 3. So that tells you that you have an unbounded response, because now tau is basically equal L over R Thevenin. L is what? 0.08 divided by minus 4,004 kilo ohms. That gives you minus 20 microseconds, which means that your IL of E is basically equal, when you plug it into this formula right here, it's going to be minus 10, minus 0.01 e to the plus, actually. It's going to be minus 0.01 plus 0.01 e to the minus 50,000, not minus, plus, to the 50,000 T amps. So T will equal 0. Okay? And now if you do V gap, notice this is going to go exponentially rise, right? Which will explode. After a while, it will destroy your inductor and your circuit, right? The V gap of T is L DIL DT. When you do that math, you plug in the Wolfram alpha, you get that this is equal to 40 e to the 50,000 T volts for T equals 0 plus. And when we get this 30 kilovolts, that means that you're going to get that, that's a time equal 132.4 microseconds. So really quickly, only a matter of microseconds, you're going to blow up your inductor and your circuit very fast.
Okay.
Any questions about this unbounded response? Any questions here?